So we now place ourselves in the loving presence of God. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day. Today it's Friday. We end the week with so much gratitude. Thank you, Lord, for the many blessings that we have experienced, for the many wonderful things that we have lived for. And above all, because you are there for us. You have accompanied us, you have loved us, inspired us, and forgiven us. We return everything to you, O Lord, as we celebrate this day with our moments of prayer, moments of gathering, friendship, brotherhood, and being a family, your family, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of St. John Paul II, one of your greatest saints in the modern time. Thank you, Lord, for inviting us always to dine with you in the table of your word, in the table of your love, the table of this friendship that we have shared together. Bless and continue to be with our loved ones, those who are not here with us, wherever they are. Bless them always, Lord, with your presence and divine love. All this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 Reading of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, you say immediately that it is going to rain, and so it does. And when you notice that the wind is blowing from the south, you say that it is going to be hot, and so it is. You hypocrites, you know how to interpret the appearance of the earth and the sky. Why do you not know how to interpret the present time? Why do you not judge for yourselves what is right? If you are to go with your opponent before a magistrate, make an effort to settle the matter on the way. Otherwise, your opponent will turn you over to the judge, and the judge hand you over to the constable, and the constable throw you into prison. I say to you, you will not be released until you have paid the last penny." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you. Good morning and good evening. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday, Father.
We continue our reflection on the eschaton towards the last days, where the Lord is inviting us to be ready. And today, perhaps I would put the reflection in this context. Jesus is the present tense of our past and the present tense of our future, because God is always present. After all, he defines himself as, "I am who I am." It means Jesus is always present. And here, Jesus engaging himself with his audience, he told them that they know the signs that are coming in. But beyond the signs of the time, he wanted to tell us and his audience to read these signs in the context of God's presence, in the context of his presence. In our language, Christian language, we always say, read the signs of the times, because the time is the kairos of God. When God is present, that is the redeeming love of God. Kairos is the time of God, more than the chronos, which is 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. But when we see God's time, we see all the events in the perspective of the redeeming act of the love of God. So much so that if I would give an example, I would like to put the language of Pope John Paul II, St. John Paul II. And today I shared in the Mass three things that are so beautiful. One, of course, is none other than when he invited humanity not to be afraid and to open their hearts to the Redeemer. It's the reading of the Pope of what's happening in the world. And only when they are not afraid, when they are courageous enough to place themselves and open their hearts to Jesus, the Redeemer, that they find love, they find consolation, they find meaning in their own existence. And so therefore, in finding meaning, they know that only Christ can give the meaning of life. Read the signs of the times, the present, every moment. should be read in the perspective of our faith, in the perspective of Jesus who is loving us. Secondly, when he invited us not to be afraid and to open our hearts to the Redeemer, he wanted to tell us in his beautiful encyclical, Dolores Salvifici, that in suffering there is redemption. That in suffering, it becomes a grace. That suffering for the sake of the Lord, it becomes a blessing as well. It is our being united with the Lord in his suffering. And that when we unite our suffering to the Lord, all our sufferings become meaningful as well. They become vicarious suffering towards his sickness and old age. And he taught us all of these things. Appreciate old age, even see sickness and embrace it. Because when you embrace sickness, old age, then they become for us reminders truly that life is wonderful and beautiful towards the fullness of our horizon with the Lord. And so therefore, he wanted to tell not to be afraid to grow old, not to be afraid in suffering, but rather embrace them in the name of faith, because there is the redeeming love of God. And lastly, he wanted to tell us, love the Blessed Virgin Mary. You realize that when he was assassinated, it was the last secret of Fatima that the Pope will be assassinated. And truly, he experienced that pain, but you see in many pictures, there was the Blessed Mother embracing him when he was shot. All the more he wanted to tell us, after all, he becomes a Marian Pope. He wanted to tell us that when we place our life in the maternal intercession of Mary, the Lord is always there. Because when Mary is there, the Lord is there. And when the Lord is there, there is the Blessed Mother, our Mother. So afraid to operate and we embrace sickness, then we come as well to realize that the Blessed Mother is journeying with us. So much so that in his example, he knew how to read the signs of the times. And these signs of the times are in the grace of God, as well as in the hands of God. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus.
For telling us.
For telling us.
Above all, for teaching us.
Above all, for teaching us.
That every event.
Every event.
Every moment.
Every person
should be read as a sign of your faith.
As a sign of your faith.
Endowed to us. As a sign of your presence. That we have to recognize. And a sign of time. To see your redeeming love. We ask for forgiveness, O Lord. For in the presence of the day, We are so preoccupied with our past. As well as of our future. Forgetting that today is your love, is your grace,
and your blessing.
Thank you, Lord, for reminding us that you are the present tense of our past and the present tense of our future.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Saints Michael, Raphael, and Gabriel,
pray for us.
Angel of God,
My guardian dear,
guardian dear, whom God's
to whom God's love commits me here, for this day be at my side, to light and guard, to rule and guide. Amen.
Amen.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony of Padua,
pray for us.
Saint Hannibal Maria di Francia,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
And O Lord,
holy apostles into your church.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And so the intercession of St. John Paul II, may God bless you all and your families, the Father and the Son, Father, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father. All,
and
good thank
morning.
You very much.
Wow.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Can
I just make one comment, question then it to Manny last night? Does
yes,
God
Father,
change mind in prayer? Because my conviction, although parang I have read this one before, the thing is, it will always say, God wants always the best for us. And He knows what we need. But it's the person who is changing mind now and then because he does not know and he's not contented of what he wants, what he needs. And so therefore, the more you pray, the more that the Lord gives and grants the best for you. Because that's the real aim of the Lord, to give us the best in life. Now, you realize that along our prayer, we become distracted. We wanted this one, but at the other hand, we change mind. We ask for this, and we rattle for so many things, as St. Augustine even would say. Mm-hmm. And at the end, we do not receive what we desire, really, what we are asking for, because we are not so clear with our mind. So God wants the best, and He does not change on that regard. But rather it's man who changes his mind. And in many ways, he does not know what to ask the Lord. And when he asks at times, it's not good for his soul. It's not good for his well-being. That's why it's not given to him. So yan lang po yung aking additional for that.
Uh-oh. Wow. Uh-oh. Thank you, Father. Oh, thank you very much, Father, for the clarification. But Father, just like regular people like us, no, now, of course we pray. And then when do we stop praying? Like, for example, we've been asking for things and then not given to you. When do we stop praying na, siguro it's not for me or maybe this is not good for my soul? When do we stop praying, Father?
Practically, if you feel you are convinced of your prayer, then you have to continue praying really until you receive either the yes or the no answer of the Lord. Now, at times, as I was saying before, if we do not receive it immediately, it's because the Lord is purifying us. So, you pwede kayo mag-change ng prayer or you have to listen really or reflect what kind you are asking from the Lord Himself. Pero, sabi niya naman, di ba, persevere because those who persevere will be saved or those who persevere will be given what is desired for. Remember the friend who asked for his friend was already sleeping. He does not wake up because of their friendship, but he woke up because of his perseverance, persistence in asking. So the persistence is also necessary. Kasi minsan, di ba, parang feel natin na parang in the mind of the person, yung Deus ex machina, di ba? Na parang the Lord is just like a machine. Now, whenever we ask, we wanted always that He gives it immediately. So prayer, persevering in prayer is also necessary in order to get what we request. Now, if we do not get at this time or for a long time, we have still to continue praying. Perhaps it's not yet the moment, yes, with patience, because perhaps our intention, our mind is not that pure or sabi nga ni Tita Bel kagabi, which was so nice, perhaps it might not be yet good for our soul. So things, God has a different perspective of seeing things for us.
Okay. Wow.
So do not stop. My prayers na kaagad sinasagot ni Lord kasi He knows that it is for the good of our soul and for His glory. If it is not yet, so really, we surrender to Him. Kasi minsan in praying, it's because we do not get because there is no room for surrendering. It's our mind only that we want the things to be given to us. But there is no surrender or total faith really to the Lord. Now, for example, di ba, may sakit, we ask for healing, no? So, sabi natin, Lord, we ask for healing. Bakit namatay siya? So, the death itself is the response of the Lord. And death becomes the total healing. It might not be physical, but in the Lord's eyes, he is healed physically, emotionally, spiritually. That person has been purified by our prayers and even by his sickness. So ultimately, the death becomes the response of the Lord.
Wow.
So, Father, we should end our prayer with your will be done.
Yes, that should be really the end of it. Your will be done, O Lord. Lord, we ask, but it is your will be done. Or if it pleases you, or if it is for the good of my soul. So those three categories, Potito. If it is for the good of my soul, if it pleases you, and your will be done. Kasi that's the will be done, it's surrendering. That it pleases you, it's our own way of adoring the Lord with all those prayers. Say for the good of our soul, that our soul will not be lost for what the Lord is giving us.
Wow. Amen. Wow.
Amen.
May prayer kasi ako, Father, na 30 years na hindi pag-granted. Sige na lang.
So it has to be, ano, ibig sabihin that the Lord is still purifying either the one who is praying or the one who is the recipient of the object. Prayer. Yes. Two ways po yan. Kasi if the other example, if you pray for the person, no, and it's not yet given, ibig sabihin it's not yet ready as well. So, you know, there should be some steps as well to be taken. Kasi when you pray, for example, if it is a person or for an event or for your success, then you have to work hard for it. Kasi hindi lang pwede na, Lord, ganito, gusto ko. But the Lord gives a lot of possibilities, inspirations of how to do it so that you will receive what you are praying for. It should be worked as well.
Continue praying lang, June. Or the way
Grace, hindi mo alam ka. Nobody knows what my prayer is. It is between me and God.
Yes, only your heart.
But just continue.
Yes, that's the thing.
Thank you.
Sooner or later.
Sooner, yes. Basta, I agree.
Just have your trust and faith.
Yes.
Baka sinagot ka na, absent ka.
Yeah, pwede rin. Tama yung kay Tito Manny.
Absent ako.
In fact, that's the meaning of the gospel of today. So you might be looking for a different answer, but the Lord has already inspired you for an answer. It could be as well, because our thinking of the answer of God is parang gusto natin yun yung gusto natin na answer ni Lord. Pero the Lord in some ways, he answers in a different way. That's why we have to discern every event, every moment. Yan lang yan. Wow. Yan lang yan. Ano, Tita Grace? Continue lang.
Just continue praying. Don't stop. Yeah. Sige.
Yes.
Pag-persevere lang. Then. Sooner or later, ma-realize kita ni Lord na ay, matagal na ito. Siguro it's high time.
Oh.
Diba? Yeah, it's true, Grace. So,
ihatag ko sa iya kay 30 years na siya nang
30 years niya nga.
Kwan nga,
Santa Monica nga. 40 years, di ba? Sa Santa Monica praying for San Agustin.
San Agustin, yes.
Oo, 40 years.
Yes. You want your prayer as well to be heard, to be expedited. Then at times there's a need of penance or fasting or sacrifice. So that could
ano yan?
You have to make some of these sacrifices.
Mga offering.
Example, Father, yes. Yes, po, Tita. For example, nung favorite food mo, Tita? Tita MJ.
Ha?
Tita MJ, anong favorite food? Oh,
ang dami talaga.
Isa lang, isa yung gustong-gusto. O minsan.
Pansit molo.
Ayun. Eh, kasi wala namang pansit molo sa ano US, di ba? Yung nandyan dyan yung palagi mo, gusto mo. So sabihin mo, today I will not eat this one or I will not buy. I will make this sacrifice even if I like so much. Example, nakita mo yung gusto mo na yun. Then sabihin mo, I will sacrifice, I will not. So for these intentions, yun. The Lord blesses those kind of offering as well.
Oh, little things, no? Pwede pala yeah. Little things.
Yes, apa. Yeah. Something that you like most at times.
Ano okay. Kaya, no, kung ano, something I like, no, like Facebook.
Oh,
yeah. Hindi ako mag-Facebook ng 1 week.
Pwedeng ganun, except for the prayer oh. Group. Except for the prayer
except
group.
Except for the prayer group. Prayer group is a messenger naman, eh. Oh.
Nah, yeah.
Little sacrifice, no?
Oh. Yes, oh yeah. O kahit one day lang muna. Paunti-unti. So, today, I will sacrifice. So, instead of browsing my Facebook, I will just offer prayer. Oh, so, ganun lang. And you know, for that intention that you are intending for. And you realize na the Lord gives it as well. Kasi may sacrifice, may fasting as well.
Kulang ng ano, kulang ng sacrifice. Tapos ang fasting pala. Go ahead, Grace. No, go ahead.
When you're saying as you are surrendering everything to the Lord, what does it mean, Father? Your whole heart, your soul, whatever?
Yeah, everything. It's the faith that you have. And in return, whatever be the answer of the Lord, you accept because you surrender.
Okay.
So the surrendering is the acceptance of the will of God. Kaya when say your will be done, it's total surrender kasi kung ano man pagbuot ni Lord, you are accepting. You're, so sabi nga, if it doesn't come kaagad according to your prayer, according to your wish, so you surrender. Lord, thank you. Then you are able to say, Lord, thank you for that. I know that this is your plan, that today I will not receive the answer to my prayer. That's surrendering. You say with gratitude as well. You put
every day.
Gratitude.
You have to be thankful.
Thank you for not answering my prayer because it's not really for me, siguro.
Wala pa.
Ganun lang, parang Lord, thank you for the day lang, you know. Although I did not receive, but I know you have a different plan for me. So yan, ganun yung mga perspective natin when we pray.
Wow.
Kasi hindi siya vending machine, ha? Na you put the coin, then something comes out. may mahulog nga soft drinks.
Kung minsan, duble pa ang hulog kaya, ng soft drinks.
yun,
kung minsan, nag-stock up pa. very nice.
No? That's the beauty of our prayerful life.
Very enlightening, Father.
Welcome, Tita.
Patience and perseverance.
Yes. That's what the Lord wants us, really.
Siyempre. Unti-unti lang ibigay talaga ni Lord, naniniwala ko niyan. Just have faith and trust Him. For many trials you have to face. Okay lang yan. Di ba, Father, in every sacrifice, there's always glory.
Ah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There is no glory when there is no suffering.
Sacrifice.
And the Lord did it. No guts, no glory. The Lord died on the cross for us, but He was resurrected. You see, the beauty, you know, too painful, but at the end, the resurrection was the greatest mystery for our Christian faith. Yeah, there's the reason even, you know, we find hope in suffering. We find contentment and peace or serenity in suffering. So not contentment, but serenity. Even when we suffer, we're at peace because we know that God is purifying us or we are uniting our sufferings with the Lord. So it becomes meaningful as well.
Wow, amen.
Amen.
Ganda, no? Ganda. Very nice, so, Father.
So okay na kayo. So we have to pray more.
pray, continue
persevere.
Continue praying.
Yes. continue praying, lift up everything. Again, diba, St. Mark, Gospel of St. Mark, chapter 11, verses 24, when you ask, pray, and believe that it's already being given to you. Given so ako minasay ko, pag hindi pa binibigay, baka yung aking faith hindi strong. Yes. Tama yung tita.
Yeah, it's true. Huh?
Pray that it is that you receive it already. Believe that you have received it already and it will be given to you. Saint Matthew would say, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock on the door. Ako, I really trusted on those prayers. And the Lord gives.
Very powerful.
Very
powerful, Father.
Yes.
Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find.
Knock and the door
shall be open to you.
And you can add Lord in your name, in the name of the Lord. Kasi the name of Jesus is the most powerful.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Yes, in Jesus' mighty name. Yeah, diba sabi ni Father, whatever you ask in the name of my Son, in the name of Jesus, I will ask. So Father, in the name of Jesus and the Holy Spirit, I ask you. Amen. Yung complete prayer would be addressed to the Father in the name of Jesus because the Father will give it to us.
In the name
like
of
what
Jesus.
Father Padre Pio said, diba?
Uh-huh.
Pray, wait, and don't worry.
Ah, yes.
Pray, don't worry.
Pray, wait, and don't worry. So we have to
pray. So when you worry, you are putting things in your hands. And not in the hands of God.
Just leave it.
Yes. Leave it in the hands of God.
Complete trust.
Complete trust.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Complete
divine
trust.
Mercy.
And it's hard, Yeah. And it's hard at times, yung complete trust.
Yeah.
Lalo na when we have our own way of seeing things, what we like. Nagmamadali tayo minsan sa answer.
In his time.
Kung gusto instant, then you take coffee, 3-in-1, Nescafe.
3-in-1.
pero yung ginasuggest ang ginaano ba Father na pray and then give thanks as if it's already given to you.
Yeah.
Test yun ang faith natin, no?
Sometimes it's not easy,
pray for something and then thank the Lord that it was like it
already
was given. Already given to you.
You receive it already.
Yeah. Oo. That means na ang faith mo is dapat is strong na strong in order to feel and sincere about what you're praying na thanking
already
him.
Given to you.
It was already given to you.
Uh-oh. Yes.
Very
you
nice,
parang
no?
claiming it already na you receive.
Yeah,
it.
You claim it already. Wow.
Yeah. Diba meron anonym na ganyan, Father, no?
Push.
Pray until something happens.
Yes.
Yes.
Mga nakasano yan, tita, na bracelet.
Oo.
Mga bata.
Diba?
Yeah, there are a lot
ano,
of
push?
Things.
Pray.
Push.
Pray until something happens.
From madami pa yung tita
Bell. Diba? Persevere din yun.
Galing nga.
Tita MJ. Gayahin mo si you imitate St. John Vianney.
Ano
nga sabi ni St. John Vianney?
Yung how he sacrificed.
For the
he
souls.
The patron saint of...
Of the priest.
Priest.
Yes.
Of the priest.
Baka mag-madre ko tito mani si tita. Pag ginayan si Mizan
din. kung tumatanggap sila ng retiree na madre, pwede.
Ako din naman siguro. Mabolunteer ako.
Volunteer ka mo.
Ginaano ko na si Sister Marivic eh.
Wow. Dami niyong volunteer ha.
Galing. May ano ha, may assisted living facility ang mga madre. May ano dyan. Sila ni Sister Marivic. Or independent
very
living facility.
Very strong yung surrendering niyo ha.
Totoo, Father.
Parang oh kahapon, nag-pray lang tayo ng vocations. Ngayon, lahat kayo magmamadre.
Parang...
Matagal na, Father.
Taling kita, Linda.
Baka yun ang answer sa send, O Lord, Holy Apostles, kaya,
into your church.
Dito, man, hindi tayo pwede magmadre.
Every day ba naman ginapray natin, said, O Lord, Holy Apostles,
O Lord,
Church, to your church. Tayo matabla, hindi
part,
tayo maano.
Part na ng blessing natin, you know, said, O Lord.
Sabi nga ni Sister Marivic, eh, punta kami doon sa Rome, hingi kami ng permission kay Pope.
Mm-hmm.
Kung tanggapin pa ako. Joke lang yan, Father.
Ay, malay mo kita, magkatotoo.
Oh my God.
No nga.
Pwede pa, Tita Grace.
Mga Saint Hannibal sister. Pwede
pa kaya ako. Permission.
Miracle happened.
Yes, oh. Tama, Tita.
Sige, Grace, mauna ka akong susunod.
Kung anong mangyari sa akin, nakita lang mo na, kumagmad... no? Ideya ka na.
Ikaw muna.
tapos, Platita, pagdating nyo, na-feel nyo na makapal pala yung damit ni na sister, mainit.
Mainit. Wala pang aircon.
Wala. Pwedeng mag-change ng damit. Gawin yung backless.
At saka chiffon.
Siguro, Father,
tapos
siguro,
yeah. Na ano,
bigyan ka naman siguro sang ano, permit. Like our sister, Sister Teresa Yasa,
wala na siya naghahabit.
Kaya ang iyabuhok medyo naglagas na. So, she was permitted not to wear the habit.
Sister
Teresa. Ihas, may ganun silang style na minsan wala silang ano. Wala silang yung kanilang habit. Yung normal lang na ano. Palda sa kablaus.
Medyo naglagas. Kada makalbo. Kaya dahil sa diabetes. Kaya yun, di na siya nag-habit.
Galing.
Hindi na siya nainitan.
Ah, very good.
May, kung may madre na nag-lipstick, papasok ako sa madre.
Magmamadre
ako. Nag-lipstick.
Tita MJ, meron. Sisters of the Holy Redeemer. Kasi kanilang apostolate is for the prostitutes. So ang ginagawa nila, pag pumupunta nila sa mga beer, sumupunta nila sa mga beer houses, tapos kinakausap yung mga ano, yung mga GRO, ganun, kunyari lang na ano, so kinakausap
tapos
nila.
They pretend as one of them, nagapretend ang madre.
They pretend lang na they are visitors as well in the ano, in the beer house, ganun.
Ah, talaga.
So, yeah, inom-inom din.
Nakakatakot kung kami ni Grace baka pick up din kami.
Ang problema lang, baka sa inyo, sasama kayo kaagad. So nawala ang sense of mission. Kawa maman si Tita Bel, hanapin kayo. Sana kayo itong
wala na, kulang ng grupo.
Nagpapick up pala.
Eh, si Tita Bel yung getaway car nyo eh. Tapos ba na wala yung dalawa? Sana po.
Ang goy.
Nakapag-inom yun.
Hello, nakalimutan ko mag-post na recording.
Ayos lang. Nice, ano.
Oh, my God.
So, take care all. Have a nice evening. Okay. Continue praying.
Thank you so much, Father.
Bye, Father. God bless.
Recording.
Do we know how to interpret the present time? It is important for us as followers of Christ to be able to look honestly at our cultures, societies, and world as a whole and interpret it honestly and accurately. We need to be able to discern the goodness and the presence of God in our world. And we need also to be able to identify and interpret the workings of the evil one in our present time. Because one of the tactics of the evil one is the use of manipulation and lies. He seeks to confuse us in many ways. These lies may come through the media, through our political leaders, and at times through some religious leaders. The evil one loves it when there is division and disorder of every kind. The church fathers offer many different interpretations. Among them, Saint Bede says that our opponent can be seen as the Word of God, in the sense that the Word of God makes war upon our weakness and sins. When we listen to the Word of God, our Lord will convict us of our faults, so that we can reconcile our lives with the truth of the Word of God Himself. When you think about God's holy word, it is in its entirety. Sometimes we try to downplay such personal convictions. We rationalize our actions and dismiss what God is saying to us. Are there any teachings of Jesus that you recall that have truly stung you to the heart? If so, this is a grace and it is an opportunity to fulfill the lesson from our Lord taught in the passage. God does not convict our hearts so as to condemn us. Rather, He convicts us as an opponent to our sin, so that we can make an effort to settle the matter on the way. Conscience is a wonderful gift from our Lord. Mark this word, conscience, our conscience. This is where God tries to communicate to us with our conscience. That's why we must have a really formed conscience. He convicts us as an opponent of our sins so that we can make an effort to settle the matter on the way. Our conscience is a wonderful gift from our Lord and can be likened to the passage above. It is a form of courtroom where our Lord desires not to have to issue punishment upon us. Instead, He desires that we engage His holy word, listen to what He says, and settle our sin by repenting immediately. Among the many lessons taught by our Lord, it is often the lesson that jumps out at us, even in a startling way, that we need to pay attention to the most. God often brings His most urgent teachings to us by causing us to feel a sense of guilt that cannot be denied. See, the conscience here is plays an important role in our life. There are sins that we feel guilt, no? And that cannot be denied. And if we feel that guilt, meaning there's something wrong. There is a wrong that we have to right, to make it right. If we listen to these convictions, then we will not have any need to stand before the judge, you see. If you feel a guilt, there is something wrong. And if we do not amend those wrong, then we will stand before the judge. But if we do not, if we bury these convictions, downplay them, and ignore them, then our Lord will find it necessary to keep at us. We will begin to experience His judgment. And we will see the effects of being out of His good graces. And in the end, if we fail to repent of the more serious sins in our lives, then we will be held accountable for the smallest of sins. We will be required to pay the last penny.
Wow.
Amen.
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 Wow. Thank you very much, Tito Manny. So enlightening, yeah. Okay, so let's go to the three pointers of Tita Linda.
Okay, the three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, often it is most difficult to see and admit the many faults that we have, the good that we have failed to do, and the sins that we have committed. Number two, this is because we do not want to face the ugliness within us, which reveals the weaknesses of our faith and relationship we have with the Lord. Number three, however, once we are able to face this reality of ourselves, we will be more open to deepening our love for our Lord and live in His ways. Amen.
Amen. Beautiful. Thank you very much, Tita Linda. So maybe this ends our prayer meeting for today. Any closing prayer? Let's pray the... Hold on. All together, we will pray the Saint Michael the Archangel for our protection and guidance, especially for our protection. All together, please. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wicked snares of the devil. May God rebuke him. We humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, draw us into hell, Satan, and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Amen.
Saint Michael,
protect
us and
pray for us, protect us and defend us. Amen.
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 In the name of the Father,
the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you very much. Good evening, Philippines.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Good
evening.
Good
morning.
Good evening. Thank you very much. Thank you for.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much for
inviting me.
Take care.
Take care, Tita Andrea.